All right, welcome to part 5 in our series on how to build a copper still, otherwise known as a moonshine still. We are building a 5-gallon copper distiller from scratch using parts from Clawhammer Supply. And in this video here, we are going to be soldering the boiler together, and I'm going to start by taking a wire brush to the seam, the inside seam of the boiler that we've already roughly shaped and riveted together. I'm just cleaning this boiler. I'm just cleaning this copper one more time with a brush here, just to make sure there's no oxidation. The cleaner you can get this copper, the better the solder is going to stick to it. And in the second video, I believe we actually roughed up all of the seams of this boiler here. So the seam that's actually lapped there has already been roughed up. And I'm just adding a little bit more, cleaning it just one more time just to make sure that, the solder sticks. Okay. So the first step here, once you have the, copper roughed up, is to apply some flux. I'm using water soluble flux. Very important to use water soluble flux. It's going to be very difficult to get the residue off if you use anything else. You can find water soluble flux at any of the big box hardware stores. We also sell it on our website, clawhammersupply.com. So go ahead and get your plumber's torch out. We're using regular propane. MAP gas is not needed. Regular propane. And I'm going to be using lead-free solder. Also very important. Lead-free plumbing solder. Also available on our website. So the key with soldering is to apply just enough heat to get the solder to melt. And no more. You can't really see what I'm doing very well here under the boiler, but as soon as that solder starts to melt, I actually remove the torch. I remove the torch from the copper, and I just let the solder melt there. I'm doing it right there. I let the solder melt, and I won't apply heat again until the solder won't melt. If you happen to apply too much heat, which I'm just about to do here, in fact, you could see it. I applied just a little bit too much heat on that last section. You can see just a little bit of the surface turned dark there. It's okay because I already had solder there. But if you apply too much heat, you're going to scorch the copper. It'll you know, sort of soot up on you, and the solder won't stick. If you apply too much heat, it turns black, it soots up. You actually are best served to just go ahead and let it cool down a little bit and hit it with the wire brush again, apply some more flux, and get that carbon buildup off of there. So just run on down the line here. Let the solder sort of fill the seam there, flow into the seam. And then as you move up the boiler wall, also hit all of the rivets. So you should have a continuous bead of solder inside of all of the rivets. You can actually solder the boiler from the outside. I used to do that. In fact, if I just were building a still for myself, I probably would do that. However, it doesn't look as clean. It's a lot easier to do that. It just doesn't look as clean. This way, you know, you have the solder here on the inside, and you really don't see any solder from the outside. All right, so once you're done soldering the inside of the boiler, you've got the seam from soldered from end to end, and the rivets are all soldered. I would suggest hitting up the wire brush one more time and cleaning that seam off. It's just easier to clean it at this point. All right, so you'll notice that we don't have a perfect cylinder at this point. So what we're going to have to do before we move on is shape the boiler. We want to, at this point, get it as round as possible. We want to make as perfect of a cylinder as we can before we drop the bottom in. It's actually a little bit easier to solder the boiler if you know, when it's not a perfect cylinder, and that seam sort of sits more flat, I guess. The parts lap together, the edges of the boiler lap together a little bit better. Though at this point, it's, you know, this is the last chance we're going to have to really straighten this thing out. So just kind of work it by hand, eyeball it. It doesn't need to be perfect, but you'll be able to get it pretty round. There we go. That looks pretty good. It looks much better than what we started with. It's more important that the bottom is round at this point than the top. So once you have a cylinder, we're going to solder the boiler bottom. What we'll do is we'll drop the bottom in. As you can see, I've already roughed up the edges of the boiler bottom here. And again, that's for the purpose of making sure that the solder sticks properly. So what I'm going to do before I drop the bottom in is I'm going to get out my flux again. This is water soluble flux, plumbing flux. I'm going to coat all of the teeth with the flux. Make sure you hit all of the teeth. And I'm even going to hit the outside just a little bit. Most of the solder is going to be on the inside, but you'll have some float around to the top, the outside of the teeth there. So make sure everything has a good layer of solder on it. And then I'm going to do the same thing to the boiler. Just work your way around the edge of the boiler bottom, both sides, top and bottom of the boiler bottom there, about a half an inch in from the edges. All right, and then what we'll do is drop the bottom in. Okay. What I like to do is take a hammer and just the blunt end of a hammer, whatever, it doesn't matter what, just tap the boiler bottom down. It doesn't take much. Tap it down so it's sitting nice and flush on the teeth there. As you can see, it's, again, these are machine cut parts. So if you have everything cleaned up before you start and you do, you're pretty much, you know, you're careful about bending those tabs, it's going to sit pretty flat. Here's the secret. Here's what I've learned. I've built a lot of these stills. What I have learned is that if you take a weight and you drop it down on top of the that boiler bottom there, it will add some pressure and push that boiler bottom down against those teeth. It's sort of a balancing act because you have to, you know, you're working on the edge of a table and you're dropping a weight down there. Now you want some of the weight to be distributed on the copper edge that you're sealing, but then you don't want it, you know, so much weight that the boiler falls off the table there. Another secret is that it is easier to solder these boiler bottoms in from the inside. So you're heating from the outside, adding the solder to the inside. And what I'm doing is I am actually starting about 4 inches away from, 3 or 4 inches away from the vertical seam. And I will work my way around the boiler until I get back to that seam. It's easiest to solder the bottom, in around the area of the seam last. So you just make your way around the boiler until you make it all the way back. And I've reached that point now, and what has happened here is that there's a tiny bit of a gap between the boiler wall and the boiler bottom, and I'm just going to take my hammer and just very lightly tap that boiler against the bottom there just to eliminate the space. And here's the secret on this seam. Apply the heat to the bottom of the still, not to the vertical wall, but to the bottom. Get a little bit of solder built up against the outside wall there, the inside, I guess, of the wall there. And then add just enough heat to the actual vertical wall there to get the solder to flow against that vertical seam there. And you're done. This one turned out pretty clean. Just inspect it, make sure that you've got solder, visible solder all the way around the bottom there, and you're done. Next video, part 6, installing the vapor cone. You won't want to miss it.